everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Suikogaiden. This is Ben and Ryu.
And Crown, this is me.
And Ruskin is 669.
Our silly voice narrator.
So
voice actor.
I'm the least serious.
Oh, well, I might as well tell you the rules. Just ignore them if you have no interest. Whether or not you listen is your own choice.
Oh no!
What did you do? Oh.
Sorry, you might hear it a little bit more than you're supposed to.
Give the double audio for a sec. Alright, sorry, I completely forgot that we were voicing this. Don't ask me why. This hole, it's so small. It's not easy to get this through.
That's what he said.
Okay, imagine, just pause.
She's
laughing.
Since
we're doing the whole voice acting thing, imagine that you're actually doing what he's doing. Because you did not sound like you were trying to fit dynamite through.
I was
shut the fuck
something.
Up!
Something to a tight, tight narrow corridor slash not throwing a hot dog down a hallway slash...
Okay, stop. Okay,
there was
stop.
No fury there, Jim.
There's so much, like, eye contact going on right now.
There was no ellipses
like,
either.
Yeah. She's leaning on your butt.
I was cursed with one of the That is you.
Yeah.
Ah.
Duh.
I'm not used to reading this.
I was cursed with one of the 27 true runes, the moon rune. When my body changed into something not human, possible for me to live with normal. I did not become the master of the moon room. Rather, it was the moon room that became my master.
Ellipses.
Day after day, the rune's evil hunger racked on my body until even reason seemed madness. I did the only thing I could. I escaped into a forest, seeking land where no humans dwelt. Deep in the forest, I built a cabin. It was small, with only one window, and not a single piece of proper furniture, but it was enough. I could live there alone, peacefully. So I lived there alone for many, many years. For decades, I lived by myself, with no one to talk to, counting the years by the forest changing colors. Flashback.
This is the most depressing music I've ever heard.
And so I lived, the days indistinguishable from years, until he appeared. If it was by the will of the gods, then I cursed them. But at that moment, I was overcome with happiness. Guided by the trees of the forest, I timidly stepped outside my cabin. He has really nice hair. A man sat, resting his back against a tree. His long silver hair flowed down past his waist. He was beautiful, like a knight from the fairy tales I had heard back when I was still human. He had been attacked by an animal, or maybe a monster. It had left a deep wound across his chest. I approached him, and he spoke, his every breath filled with pain.
He's gonna die.
He's on a car. Putting a bell on our
arms. This is you, Risk.
Hoo-hoo! I'm an owl.
We get double audio.
All the ellipses.
I was scared. It had been hundreds of years since I had spoken with anyone.
Where am I?
Please don't.
Please. Near here. This is Dr. Seuss. There is a carriage. The lady.
Oh no. A carriage, but...
Photoshop a fedora on his head.
Yeah. I do not sense the presence of any humans aside from you.
Blaze! Ellipses! A lady! Ellipses!
A carriage? I understand.
She doesn't seem like the non-serious type.
I had gone to such lengths to avoid humans, but I cannot deny the fact that my heart was nearly bursting with joy. I thought I had forgotten how to speak. I searched the forest. I wanted to grant the knight's request. I wanted to fulfill the wish of a human. I soon discovered the carriage and the remains of a woman. I returned to the knight.
Da 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 da. A lady.
Thank you, that's a little bit better.
I see. Come, Herc.
That's cough, actually.
Cough, Herc.
Are you okay?
cough, cough, ellipses. It seems. My life is ellipses at its end, ellipses. They need to know about the ellipses. What a waste. I sound like I'm pain. In pain. I couldn't even protect my lady. And now I can't even get my revenge. Dying her here is...
Dying her.
Her! Man, can you say anything besides dots?
Maddening.
It's maddening exclamation. What was my life for? Question mark exclamation. What did I learn the art of the sword for? Question mark S exclamation. What was the point of the oath I swore? Damn this place.
Me too.
I'm cursed. My whole life is cursed. I do not fear death. Exclamation. If this is my fate, I accept it. Exclamation. Even so, this is a disgrace. The voice acting part, at least.
Yeah.
Upon my honor.
Do the quote.
It's maddening. I don't know it by heart.
As he spoke, the knight started crying. Genuine tears of sadness. At that moment, I felt sorrow. Whether it was because I was about to see a human I had spoken with disappear, or because I hated him for obtaining the gift of death that I wished to spend all of my life in the darkness. But I say there is still a good reason to keep you here on this earth.
Am I
Mahjong? What are you?
It's a hollow light, but...
It's your face!
Nobody said anything.
I really hope he's picking you up, honestly.
Oh, she's sucking on his neck.
That was the first time I drank the blood of a human. Although I knew that I should not spread the curse, I acted out of compassion. But what I felt then, it was not true compassion.
It's that ass.
I was gonna say selfish.
Ooh, back up.
I took the man's blood and gave him mine. Our blood mixed and became one, and so was born one who shared the same fate as I. The man said his name was Reed. As he regained consciousness, and while his wounds began to heal, I told him of my tale. The day after he learned what had happened to him, he disappeared. I waited for him. I kept waiting, even while thinking that he might never return. But as far as I was concerned, I had plenty of time to spare. Before long, Green returned. He did not talk about what he had been doing. Whether he had pursued his responsibilities or his revenge, I did not know. And I did not want to know. After that, we spent many long years together. Together, we found hidden strength in ourselves. What I could not understand on my own, I discovered with Reed, and I was happy. And so we spent 1,000 days of rain and 1,000 days of wind. Time flowed by slowly for a long time. Over the course of an eternity, Reen and I met more and more people who came to the forest seeking deliverance. At those times, I gave life to those who rejected death. Little by little, our circle grew bigger. Before we knew it, our gathering was a village.
Damn, this bitch likes to talk.
She's telling a story, motherfucker! Where you at? We named it the Village of the Blue Moon. By that time, I had finally become someone who could truly be called the master of the moon. Thanks to Reen's help.
Yeah, yeah.
In the center of the village, we built an altar and enshrined the rune there. Yes.
I'm Reen.
This way, the villagers were able to live under the rune's protection, away from the eyes of the humans. Everyone thought that we could continue living contentedly that way. But living as we did, I had forgotten. Or I had tried to forget. How the hearts of humans change. How they were made of the most fragile glass in the world. The incident happened without warning. One of the villagers stole the moon rune and ran away to the outside world. His name was Neckbord.
Fuck him.
It had not been long since he had joined us, but he was young, good-natured. Oh, he was a young, good-natured fellow, well-liked by all. I was still protected by the rune as the founder, but the same did not hold true for the other villagers, and after Neckbord's
death, I began to experience a true death.
Experience perishing.
Whatever.
Thank you, Risk.
Y'all can read.
I'm not a cook!
You may find it hard to believe, but almost all the villagers accepted death peacefully. Maybe they were tired of living, I do not know. I apologized as they endured the excruciating pain, but some even smiled as they left me behind. However, some refused such a death and ran away to the outside world. Rean was one of them. After losing the protection of the rune, there was only one way the villagers could survive. To accept the curse of vampires and feed on the blood of humans.
Sounds tasty.
By stealing the souls of humans, they could cling to their lives for all eternity. Crude, ugly, despicable, that is what Rean has chosen to become. And that is why I was killed with my own hands. I gave him life. I shared a life with him. I will not let him sully those memories.
Unflashback.
Yeah, right? Are you gonna cry? She's like, damn, we're both dead asleep.
Like, I gave up.
Sorry for the wait, Sarah. I'm done.
You fool. Because you took so long, I've said too much.
Too much?
Sorry about that. But actually, I was fucking so hard at the end that I wasn't really listening.
Yeah.
How very like you.
He just said, bitch, you talk too much.
That was loud.
Explosions. Just blew up the door.
We broke
through the iron door and climbed the spiral staircase beyond to the top of the tower. Yeah, it's my turn to talk!
I forgot.
The forest lay a solemn chapel.
Come on, go in his character that I can do stuff with.
Happy as an accomplishment.
I can speak!
I can advise!
Sarah! Illuminated by the moonlight streaming through the colorful stained glass window, sat a figure, an elegant young man quietly paying the pipe organ because every sinister motherfucker has a pipe organ.
I know you was making such a racket at this time.
I twist a bunch of keys too.
But I must say, I never expected it to be you, Sarah, whatever her name is.
Yes.
Why is Dracula a character in the show?
It has been a long time. I did not know where you had gone, but now I have finally found you.
Or so you think. I see. Since then. I wonder. Goddamn these ellipses! How much time has passed?
They're pauses, motherfucker!
These days without you, man, I saw a retarded pausing like every 3 seconds. You, I sound like.
Stop spouting nonsense.
William Shatner, that's what I sound like.
The transient life I gave you, I will have you return.
Is that so, question mark? I see how like you. How very like you, Sarah.
Have you preyed on humans?
You have preyed on humans.
Oh. For the sake of pleasure and prolonging your own life, you have devoured the blood of humans and toyed with their lives. What have you done? What you have done is unforgivable.
Grabber!
Today, I have sentenced Lexia.
Quotation, by the way. That is the true form of the moon rune. Period. We are vampires, Sarah. What? This is the way it should be. Dot, dot, dot. You know how it feels. Dot, dot, dot. That sweet, pleasant taste. Dot, dot. When you drink my blood.
Silence.
There are 2 exclamation points. You could have at least gone 3 octaves.
Sarah! Why? Why must you live in fear? Why must we who are not human have human hearts? What is the reason for that? Why am I asking so many questions? Why must we with our bodies brimming with power hide like creatures of darkness when we are superior to humans and my voice sucks? Sarah, don't tell me you still pretend you're human! Poor Sarah!
Oh my god.
I told you to stop spouting nonsense. Have you forgotten? That day you said, if this is my fate, I accept it, did you not? Though you said that, you still fight for life when you should have returned it to me. If you could not do that, then the only thing waiting for you was perishing. Now there is only one choice left.
Sandwiches. Sarah! I love that. She totally stabbed him.
That was a bit harsher than expected. And we'll find out where this leads next time on Let's Play Suikogaiden. This is Banditryu.
I got it, she's a meme.
And I'm dying.
That game sucks.